Good morning, dear students. This is Dr. Savita Tidme. I welcome you all in the next lecture of the subject Economic Zoology. And in the present lecture, we'll be studying chapter number 8, Concept of Coral Reef, from the subject Economic Zoology, under which we will be studying specifically, the focus will be given on the topic Concept of Coral Reef and its significance, why it is important to us. So these two things will be studying in present lecture. In previous lectures, we have studied the sponge culture and its importance. Even we also studied the different animal rearing, dairy culture or dairy industry, even the apiculture, pisciculture, number of things like goat farming or something like that. So lot many things we have already studied in previous few lectures, and even the pest, useful insect as well as harmful insect, that also we studied. So different kinds of pest we also studied. Now in the present lecture, we will be studying the concept of a coral reef. What are the coral reefs? Okay, and how they are important to us, how they are useful to us. Let's move ahead and see. Okay, so coral reefs are some of the most diverse ecosystem in the world. If you see the coral reefs, they are showing a lot of variations. They are very diverse in their appearance, in their, even you can say, biology, right? So this diverse, one of the most diverse ecosystem in the world, how the corals form. Okay, see this beautiful structure, this is nothing but the coral. Okay, and all these different types of polyps are there, and they are present where? They are present on the pre-existing one. These are all nothing but the corals, right? These are coral reef, and these are live corals, or you can say polyps, colonies of the polyps. Okay, now corals, they formed from the polyps, so they called as a coral polyps. Means the polyps which are going to form the coral reef, said to be coral polyps. And what is the coral polyp, or what is the polyps? Polyps are the animal primarily responsible for building the coral reefs, right? So they are the individual. Polyps are the individual. Here I have shown, right? Polyps are the individual which are responsible for building the coral reefs. They can take many forms. Larger reef building colonies they may form. Even the graceful flowering fans like this, they also form like this. Graceful flowering plants, they also form. Even along with that, the small colonies they may form. Solitary organisms are also found to be exist, like sea anemone. Okay, so polyps, they belong to the phylum Cylindrata, right? And these cylindrically bodied animals, basically cylindrates, they have two main types of individuals in them, polyps and medusa. These two are the forms exist, and one is this medusa, are said to be the motile one. And polyps, they are nothing but the sedentary one. They get settled to the bottom, right? And all the polyps, or you can say all the coral reefs, they are formed by these polyps. How they form the coral reefs, that we are going to study in detail. Okay. Now, all right. This is what I said. These are the fans of the coral, or you can say polyps, beautifully produced colonies of the polyps. All these are said to be the corals. Okay, coral reef. Okay, now the coral reefs are the large underwater structures composed of the skeleton of colonial marine invertebrate. How the coral reefs, they form live polyps, live colonies of the polyps. They cannot form a coral, but when they used to deposit the hard material, calcium carbonate, around their body as an exoskeleton. Later on, the polyps get die off, and that hard exoskeleton, it forms a strong coral reefs. right? So these coral reefs, they are nothing but what? Nothing but the exoskeleton of the colonial marine invertebrate. Exoskeleton, or you can say simply the skeleton of the marine invertebrate, nothing but the polyps. And this coral species that builds a reef are known as, see, not, it is not like all the hydra, or you can say all the polyps, they form coral reefs. No, it is not like that. Some specific species are there, or you can say few species are there, they form a coral reef. Few species are there, they could not form the coral reefs. So depending upon that, here two types of corals are there. So coral species that builds a reef are known as hermatypic or hard coral. So what they called? They called hermatypic. So hermatypic means hard coral. So what they means? They are nothing but the corals which have a capacity or ability to deposit calcium carbonate as an part of their exoskeleton to form the exoskeleton of the calcium carbonate. So this calcium carbonate is extracted, or you can say it is been isolated, selected, extracted from the seawater, and it is deposited as an harder part, hard exoskeleton around and inside their bodies and forms the coral, right? So it is not like all the polyps, they form the coral reefs. No, some polyps are there, or some species of the corals, they are not able to build such a coral reefs. So this is called as soft corals. If the hard corals are nothing but the coral reef building animals, so they called as a hard coral, and soft one which have no ability to build the coral reefs. Okay, along with that, they are also called as a hermatypic reefs or a hermatypic corals. Like here, it is said hermatypic means a hard coral, soft coral, a hermatypic. Okay. Alright. Now, so these corals, where do they found? Okay. Where do they found? They found all over the world's oceans. If you go anywhere, you may find some patches of the corals. You may find some fringing corals. Right? Like that. It's different types of corals are there. So all these corals, it means it is not like restricted to some kind of a specific sea. No, the corals, or you can say coral polyps, they have been observed to be present, to be grown in varieties of oceans, like in extremely colder oceans of the Alaska, right? Extremely colder oceans of Alaska, as well as warmer oceans like the Caribbean Sea. It means the coral polyps, they are well adapted to live in different varieties of oceanic environment. No doubt, my dear students, it is not like there is only one or two species of the coral that is responsible for building a coral reef. No. Hundreds or thousands of species of polyps are there which are responsible for formation of the coral reef, right? But important of all, who can build a coral reef? See, this is one of the world's largest coral reef ever found, right? So who is responsible, or how they can build a coral reef? High, we can say tough islands like patches in the sea, right? So these kind of coral reefs can be possible if the ocean, or in the clear shallow water of the tropic and subtropic regions. In most of the tropic and subtropic oceans, especially towards the seashore, where there is a shallow water, where the coral reef they mostly found. Okay, it doesn't mean the coral reefs they are not exist in the middle of the ocean. It is existed there, but the chances of occurrence of the coral reefs, or chances of formation of the coral reefs, is more in the shallow water as compared to the deep ocean, right? Okay. So in the colder oceans, coral reefs, they are very rare to observe, but in the tropic and subtropical oceans, they are easily observed. So, largest coral reef ever found is the Great Barrier Reef in Australia. So, Australian Great Barrier Reef is specially formed by the corals, coral polyps, and it is one of the world's greatest coral reef ever found. And how? What is the size of this coral reef? One may ask a question, right? So, the size of the coral reef, that is world's greatest barrier reef, is 1,500 miles long. It is near about 2,400 kilometers. Can you imagine, students? 2,400 kilometers. It is quite, means it is a far, far, far big coral reef. That is why it is considered to be world's greatest coral reef, right? And it is called as a Great Barrier Reef because it is going to separate, going to form a barrier from the ocean water as well as from the lagoon, we can see. So, it's going to form a partition, hence called as a barrier reef, right? So, this world's greatest barrier reef is measured about 2,400 kilometers and it is observed in Australia. So most of the substantial coral reefs which nowadays we are watching, we are seeing such a coral reefs. So what would be the age of the corals? Any guesses? Yes, the age of the coral reefs, the substantial coral reefs which we found today, is minimum 5,000 to 10,000 years old. And what is human life? Near about 60 to 80 years. And what is the reef, coral reef's life? 5,000 to 10,000 years. So, you can imagine, it's a small individual which going to form the coral reefs, like hundreds or thousands kilometers of the coral reefs. It is not even an easy task for this member also. It forms a colonies like this, right? Coral colonies are there, polyp colonies are there. Again, they used to deposit calcium carbonate around and inside their body so that they become so hard, tough, and can withstand in a sea, can withstand in an ocean. And younger polyps, they keep on growing on such a hard, tough surfaces so that they build a coral, they build a stage, you can say coral, yes, reefs on one above another. So they going to harbor the younger one, the older one going to harbor the younger one so that they can grow further, they can become harder and make the coral reef. So such a coral reefs, they are minimum having 5,000 to 10,000 years old. Nowadays they are exist. So you can imagine how much time is required to form such a coral, big coral reef in nature. Right, okay. Then why corals, they are important to us, or why the corals, they are important for the ocean even? So about 25% of all known marine species of the animals, they rely on the coral reef for food, shelter and breeding, right? About 25% of all marine species, they depend on the corals, coral reefs for food, for shelter, for breeding. All right. Now these corals, as they're going to harbor number of small organisms, small plantlets, even you can see here, small plantlets may found on them, may grow on them, even the animals, they may find their breeding places, residing areas on the coral. Even the sponges, they are also growing on this coral reefs, right? So the coral reefs, they form such a hiding places or breeding areas for number of sea animals. Even they are also useful for, so number of such a animals, aquatic animals, are depend on the coral reefs for their food, for their shelter, as well as in breeding areas. So sometimes these coral reefs, they are referred as the rainforest of the sea for their biodiversity. If you see the rainforest ecosystem, it is highly diverse. You can get number of different types of plant, number of different types of grasses, even number of different types of animals, birds, insect. So it is highly diverse ecosystem. Similarly, these corals, they are also indicated as the rainforest of the sea for their biodiversity. Why? Because they are going to harbor number of animals on their body. Even they are providing food to them, even they are providing shelter as well as breeding areas, and hence they are world's diverse, means the greatest diverse ecosystems, right? And so called as a rainforest of the sea. So these coral reefs are the primary habitat for more than 4,000 species of fish. What they are the primary habitat for more than 4,000 species of fish. You can see even 7,000 species of the corals and thousands of other plant and animals. For them, the coral reef, they are surviving as a primary habitat, right? So habitat is what? Habitat is a place where animals are residing, where animals are living, right? So coral reefs, they form such a residing places or such a places where thousands of 4,000 of species of fishes, they reside, they live there between the corals, on the corals, inside the corals, right? Even 7,000 species of coral itself. What it means? Yes, it means this. These are the coral reefs. Okay, still they are underwater, but they will grow up and come to the ocean surface. So such a different types of varieties of young polyps, they grow on the coral, pre-existing coral. They increase in the number, they increase in the size, even they deposit calcium carbonate inside and outside their body so as to form the hard, tough exoskeleton. And then these bodies, or you can say such a coral polyp turn to coral reef, right? So the older coral reefs, they harbor 700 species of the coral polyps, right? And these coral polyps later on involved in or useful for formation of the coral reef. So thousands of species of plants and animals, they are also found to be depend on or found to be living on the coral reefs, right? So apart from that, the coral reefs, they are typically divided into four categories. How many categories? Four categories coral reefs they are divided. The first category is the fringing reefs, barrier reefs, patch reef, and atolls. So this fringing reef, here I have shown the fringing reef. It is some diagram I got through the Google source, and here is the source located. All right. So this fringing reef, what it means, the fringing reef is nothing but a coral reef, or you can say a coral band exists near the coastline of the ocean. Specifically, what is the specific characteristic? Coral reef exists close to the border of the ocean or coastline of the ocean. This is small mountain, small whatever islands is there, and here is the light green color, coral reef is there. So this is called as a fringing reef, right? Fringing reefs, and these reefs exist near the coastal area or marginal area of the ocean. All right. Then the second type is the barrier reefs. So these barrier reefs, they forms a continuous patch, or you can say continuous band around or towards the coastline, or you can say between the coastline and the middle ocean, so that they can able to separate the lagoon and then oceanic part, right? All right, here it is shown. These are the patch reefs. Okay, patch reefs, and here there is a barrier reef, a continuous barrier reef which is going to separate this ocean and this lagoon area or shallow oceanic part, right? So this is the main barrier reef, and such a barrier reefs, they are useful for making partition in the lagoon or against the shallow water and deep water of the ocean. Then patch rifts. Sometimes the corals, they may form a patches of coral rifts, patches of the islands, and such a patches are again significant, right? And they are no doubt going to harbor number of plants and animals on them. So you can see here patch rifts, especially they observe towards the shallow water or margin of the ocean, that is coastal, close to the coastal area. Because here you can see deep ocean is there, and this is the barrier reef running around, and this barrier reef is going to separate this shallow water and deep water, and then inside the shallow water you can see here patches of the coral reef, so called as a patch reef. Now the most interesting is atolls. So these atolls are nothing but the coral rifts which form in the middle of the ocean, especially in the deep water, right? In the middle of the ocean, they form a circle, a band of the coral reef in the ocean, and especially these atolls, they form close to the islands which have been sink into the ocean. Close to the islands which have been sinked deep into the ocean. See, this mountain was quite high above the sea level. Slowly, slowly it gets dipped down into the sea level. So here it is completely inside the or underwater. The coral reefs, if form around such a or yes, around such a islands. It's not islands actually, around such a underwater islands. So these are said to be the atolls. Okay, atolls. So coral reefs typically divided into four categories: fringing reefs, barrier reefs, patch reefs, atolls. Okay. Now let's see few of the important characteristic of the coral. Shallow waters. Okay. Shallow water coral reef building coast. Alright. So inside the shallow water, reef building corals have a symbiotic relationship with the photosynthetic algae called as zooxanthellae. So that zooxanthellae is one of the photosynthetic algae observed inside the shallow water coral polyps. So here I can show you. Here they are the shallow water polyps. This is the colony of the polyps, and inside them here you can see some specific dark colored structure. That dark colored structure is nothing but the zooxanthellae. So these zooxanthellae is a photosynthetic algae that live inside the coral polyps. Okay, that live inside the coral polyps. Now it is symbiotic in nature, no doubt. Symbiotic association is there in which no one is harmed, but especially it is of a mutualism. Symbiotic association in which no one is at harm, but mutualism in which no one is harmed, but both are at benefit. Right? Both are at benefit. Now, what benefit is received in this mutual association? Let's see. So, this zooxanthellae, which is a small photosynthetic algae that is found in the ocean. So, it lives inside the coral polyp. It lives inside the polyp, this cylindrical animal. Inside its body, this zooxanthellae is living. So ultimately zooxanthellae means this algae is getting protection from the coral, right? As well as they are also getting shelter from the coral and some kind of a nutrient, or you can say elements that are required for photosynthesis, is also make available for the zooxanthellae or the photosynthetic algae. So ultimately the photosynthetic algae zooxanthellae is at benefit, right? And let's see what benefit is received by this coral polyp. So this coral polyp, as it's an animal in origin, so it do not prepare its own food material, right? It has to depend on other animal for the food, maybe the phytoplankton, maybe zooplankton. Now here in this case, the shallow water polyps, they shows inside their body, they shows presence of this photosynthetic algae, that is zooxanthellae. Now this zooxanthellae is carrying out photosynthesis, and during photosynthesis they release oxygen. That oxygen is utilized by this coral polyp, right? Even it also produces carbohydrate that is used as a source of food, or that is used as a food by this coral polyp, right? So ultimately this one more is remaining. This zooxanthellae also help polyp for removal of the waste material. So ultimately this coral polyps, they receives food, they receives oxygen, they get clean because of the presence of photosynthetic algae zooxanthellae inside them. And zooxanthellae, they get protection, they get shelter as well as element for photosynthesis. So in this kind of a symbiotic association, both the members, that is coral polyp and coral zooxanthellae, okay, both of them, they are at benefit. So such a kind of association is mutualism. Now the deep sea coral that live in a much deeper or colder oceanic water, and those deep sea coral polyp, they lack zooxanthellae. So inside them zooxanthellae is not found, because in the deeper sea sunlight cannot reach, and if there is no sunlight, how the photosynthesis is done? So ultimately these photosynthetic algae zooxanthellae, they cannot survive at the deep ocean, right? So in the shallow water coral polyps, this zooxanthellae, they can found, because where sunlight easily reached, and ultimately they can carry out photosynthesis, they can survive. No, okay. So unlike their shallow water relatives, which rely heavily on the photosynthesis to produce the food, the deep water, deep sea coral take in. As a deep sea coral, they don't bear, they don't have photosynthetic algae called as zooxanthellae. They don't have. Deep sea coral, they don't bear zooxanthellae. So ultimately there is no photosynthesis, no carbohydrate available for them. So what would be the source of food? Plankton, zooplanktons, phytoplanktons. So these planktons are taken in as a source of food, as well as some organic matter, organic debris, right? These are used for fulfilling their daily requirement of energy, right? So coral characteristic little bit we have seen. Now let's see what is the significance of a coral, why one should study the coral, or why and how corals are useful to us. All right, now the coral reefs protect coastline from the storms and erosion. All right, whenever okay, you might have seen the storm, oceanic storm, right? So that can even tsunami, you might have seen the tsunamis when they come on the land, it destroys human habitat, it destroys nearby coastal area, right? So if coral reefs are there, coral reefs are present nearby the nearby, or you can say close to the coastal area, so they are going to prevent the storm which is reaching to the land, or even they are also act as a protective cover from such a destructive natural calamities. Even the erosion of the soil, which is getting washed along with the every tide, so that is also been prevented. So the coral reefs, they are useful component for the point of ecosystem, health of the ecosystem, right? So it provides job for local communities and offers opportunities for recreation. So local communities, whenever if there is any kind of a coral reef, it becomes a tourist place, and people, they used to visit that coral reefs, they used to enjoy there, right? So local people, they may get opportunities, they may get money through such a recreation opportunities, or you can say the amusement opportunities. Even they are also a source of a food and medicines. Food, they are the source of food for number of oceanic animals, right? And they are the source of medicine. Now one can ask a question, how the corals or coral polyps, they act as a source of medicine. So, my dear students, the coral, they used to harbor number of plants, they used to harbor number of animals, sponges on their body. Do you remember? Yes. And all of them. Okay. All of them. Number of plants, animals, which are residing on the corals, as well as they depend on the corals. So they contains, along with this corals, polyps, they contains some kind of antioxidants as well as anti-cancerous agent. So the medicinal property or medicinal components which are retrieved from such a coral animals or corals, they are useful for preparation of the antioxidant. They are useful for preparation of the antibiotic, antiviral, antifungal drugs or medicines. So the corals, they are important for human as a source of medicine. Coral reefs, they are useful for the human as a source of medicines. Even coral reefs, as they are residing or they are present in the ocean since long time back, like 10,000, 50,000, 20,000 years old. So they are producing some kind of chemicals which keep them stable in the salt water. So on that point of view, scientists, they are also nowadays working whether we can get some kind of a material which is useful for the human health or for the nourishing human being. Like, that research is still going on, but they are useful component as a aspect or point of a medicines. So over 500,000 people depend on the reefs for their food, income and protection, that we have already studied. Now, fishing, diving and snorkeling on and near the reefs add hundreds of millions of dollars to the local businesses. Okay, fishing, diving on or near by the coral is again one of the popular game might have seen. So, okay, fishing on the reefs or fishing as well as diving on the reefs, it is one of the important for human. Because reefs, almost maximum reefs, coral reefs, they are found nearby the coastal area. So it becomes easy for the people to dive into the protected safe area. It provides us a safe environment for the diving, right? And snorkeling on and near the reefs. Snorkeling means what? Snorkeling is now a new terminology for you. Snorkeling is nothing but underwater diving, like this. Underwater diving by using a mask, right? This entire mask as well as a snorkel tube. So whatever this siphoning tube is there, breathing tube is there, it is called as a snorkel. And the person or the mask using the snorkel is said to be the snorkeling. Not the person, but the process of it diving, underwater diving by using this snorkel is said to be snorkeling. So this snorkeling kind of a diving is also important, and that gives money, a lot of money, millions of dollars to the local communities, local business, right? So the net income, net economic value of the world's coral reef is estimated to be nearly 10 million of US dollars. How much it is? 10 millions of US dollar yearly. The people, they are earning through the coral reefs, businesses related to the coral reefs. So it is economically important, right? And at the last, these ecosystems are culturally important to indigenous people around the world. Their mythological stories or some kind of religious things, they are connected with the coral reefs. And these cultural things, mythological things, they are useful for protecting the corals. Because of that, they used to protect the corals, they do not destroy them, and hence it gives them money through different businesses associated with it. So with this, my dear students, we have completed the coral concept of a coral, what kind of corals are there, how they form, even different how the corals, they live symbiotically with the zooxanthellae, and what are the significance of the coral ribs. So, my dear students, these are the resources site from which I have taken entire study material, right? And we acknowledge them. Thank you.